if I'm getting my chronology right, you knew Sean Collier.
I did.
In the academy?
Yes, I met him in the academy. We drove in the academy every day together. And then, you know, on the weekends we'd hang out together. It was weird, you know, it's like nobody could get enough. We couldn't get enough of each other during the week. Then we'd hang out on the weekends.
But if we could reconstruct it, what's the first call that starts that whole cycle?
It's that there was, you know, an officer down and over in Cambridge. And downtown isn't too far from Cambridge, especially, you know, 11:30 at night.
And an officer down call, everybody goes.
That's right. So, you know, hit the lights and get out there. And apparently I was the second transit police officer out there. I put two and two together, talked to some other folks, found out who it was. I actually tried to call my wife, who didn't pick up the phone, thank goodness.
I mean, to tell her it wasn't you.
Well, that and to tell her who it was, because I was like a good friend of mine, you know, a little shaken up. And I called his roommate and told him, you know, head to MGH, just go right there. And he, you know, he figured out what happened, and he headed there instead of coming to the scene, and that was that.
Did you have any idea at any point that you were looking for the Boston Marathon bombers?
Once we got on scene, and there was gunfire being exchanged, and once they started throwing the bombs or improvised explosive devices, I'm pretty sure I did. I like to think so. I think we probably, you know, looked at each other, and you don't even need to say a word. You're like, this is it. These are the guys.